ladies and gentlemen, Garry Moore. Yay!
Thank you for the introduction, Bill Wendell. You've lost a little weight. I doubt that there's anybody in the world, all kidding aside, who didn't recognize that marvelous cartoon character, Yogi Bear, one of America's favorites. Our first contestant up here, at least one of the first three, is going to be one of the co-creators of Yogi Bear, and we'll meet the talented chap right after good old Yogi introduces our bare-faced panel right here on To Tell the Truth.
Here's Bill Cullen. And Peggy Cass. With my old buddy, Nipsey Russell. And Kitty Carlisle. Certainly better than the average panel.
Now, wasn't that a splendid introduction?
Yes.
I tell you that Yogi Bear has got class, and I can't see any reason why we don't let him just keep right on working. So let's let Daws Butler, who is the voice of Yogi Bear, introduce our first team of challengers.
To tell the truth, this is Daws Butler, the voice of yours truly, Yogi Bear. Yay! Created by Bill Hanna and Joe Barbera. And one of these gentlemen is one of my bosses, Mr. Bill Hanna. Yay!
Number one, what is your name, please?
My name is Bill Hanna.
Number two.
My name is Bill Hanna.
Number three.
My name is Bill Hanna.
And here is the animated announcement of Bill Hanna. I, Bill Hanna, am one half of Hanna-Barbera Productions, the world's largest animation studio. Indeed, we've produced more cartoon series than anyone else in the business. Over 100 series in all. Currently, we're responsible for about half of the Saturday morning television programs for children. In addition to Yogi Bear, from whom you've just heard, other Hanna-Barbera creations are the Banana Splits, Huckleberry Hound, and the Flintstones. We also produced the fully animated musical motion picture of the E.B. White classic, Charlotte's Web. And it's a source of great pride that our Tom and Jerry cartoon series won 7 consecutive Academy Awards. Signed, Bill Hanna. And that's a mess of awards. And we'll be right back to play the game after a mess of commercials. Away from us, we have 3 many times awarded gentlemen, all of them claiming to be Bill Hanna, co-creator with Joe Barbera of Yogi Bear and many more cartoon characters. And Nipsey Russell, let's see what you want to find out.
Number two, there is some discussion in animation that what's being played on the screens now is not true animation, that they're just figures with maybe the mouth moving, but the real animation would move every part of the body. Do you know the source of that criticism?
No, not at all.
Have you heard it, number two?
No, none whatsoever.
All right. Now, number three, if you had a figure and you had wanted it to move rapidly, would you make less or more drawings?
If you wanted to move rapidly, you'd have to have more drawings, but you would have to increase the frames.
I see. Number one, do you know who produces Looney Tunes?
Looney Tunes, I don't think are being produced now.
I see. Number two, again, there was a classic cartoon called Country Cousin. Do you know who produced that film?
Could have been Screen Gems. I'm not sure.
It was an animated cartoon.
Yes.
I see. Number three, what about foreign product? How does it compare with the American productions?
Well, I think you'd say that the foreign people do more of an aesthetic kind of type cartoon that we than we do here.
Thank you, Nipsey. Let's go to Please to Kitty.
Number one, is Smokey the Bear ever confused with Yogi Bear?
I don't think he is at all, no.
That's funny. I confused him.
You thought you were being introduced by Smokey, did you?
Number two, would you say that the moral content of cartoons has changed since you've been in the business?
Oh, yes. Obviously, as you well know, they're mainly directed for early morning Saturday shows, the youth, the young adults, the 5 and 6 year olds, and it's actually they're a plus in relation to the violence that you do, rest of the violence you see on TV.
Yeah, thank you. Number three, but there's been a tremendous sort of urge to have the children see less violent things and so forth. Has the morality of the cartoon changed in your day?
I really don't think so.
It's always been the same.
I think so.
Number one, who did Crazy Cat?
Crazy Cat was made in New York by...
That's all right. I got confused with Smokey the Bear and Yoga Bear, so...
And we're going on down, please, to Bill Cullen.
Number two, when I was going to the movies every Saturday with a dime in my pocket, in addition to the Disney things, the Mickey Mouse characters and things like that, Popeye was very big. Do you know what studio produced Popeye or who produced it?
I'm not sure. Again, it might have been Screen Gems. I'm not actually sure.
Number one, there was a cartoon that won a big prize in motion pictures a few years ago, like 5 or 6, and it was just a colored blob, and it was a voiceover just describing what that blob was doing in dialect. Do you know who the voiceover was on that particular one? I think it was called The Blob. I don't know, but it was about a blob. The Blob.
B-L-U-B.
Did it win an Academy Award?
I wouldn't say it's an Academy Award, a motion picture award of some kind. I remember it.
I'm sorry, I don't recall that.
Number two.
And on to Peggy Cass.
Number three, you said that, somebody said that the cartoons aren't as violent as they used to be, but Tom and Jerry's still good and violent, wouldn't you say?
Well, that's what I said before. They hadn't changed. I said they were still violent.
Oh, well, I'm with you. I love Tom and Jerry. That's my all-time favorite. Now, they... How good. Number one, did you start out with Walt Disney?
No, I have never worked for Walt Disney.
Thank you. Number two, did you have to pay a royalty to Yogi Berra to use that name Yogi Bear?
Not at all.
Did he object at all?
There was some flack, but it was sort of a laughing thing. It was...
Number three, who's the voice of Woody Woodpecker? Number three?
I don't know.
Do you know, number one, if there's any woman in California that does voiceover for animals?
For animals?
Yeah, you know, like for
yes,
cartoon people.
Yes, I do.
Thank you. Number two, who makes Roadrunner? That's another one I like. If you say Screen Gems, I'm not going to vote for you.
There's a Viz-a-com Productions that could do. I'm quite sure it did that.
Thank you.
This began to sound a little bit like a Senate hearing. I never heard so many evasive answers in my life. But based on what you've learned or what you haven't learned, friends, you're going to have to mark your ballots. You're going to have to make the following numbers. Choose amongst them. A 1. Or a 2. Or a 3. And the situation is we pay $50 to the group for each wrong vote. We pay them $500 if nobody comes up with the real Bill Hanna, and Nipsey starts.
Well, I voted for number one, possibly because I thought that he gave me the least bit of misguidance. And I counted number two out because there's a great furor about whether or not that really constitutes animation, what appears on the screens and on television today.
Very well, so we got a 1 going, and now we're going to Kitty.
Well, I nearly voted for number one because he looks like Yogi Bear. And number two is obviously an executive for Screen Gems. And number three looks like an actor. But I voted for number three.
Number one looks like Yogi Bear?
Yeah, Yogi Bear.
Yogi Bear, number one.
Yogi
Bear.
Well, all right. Let's go on to Bill Cullen.
How come the conclusion from these answers that there's no Bill Hanna over there? These are all animations. And I voted for number three because his lips move with the words better than the other bunch there.
And so we got a pair of threes and a 1 and Peggy.
Oh, I think that the real one would have known that Gracie Lance, Walter Lance's wife, is the voice of Woody Woodpecker. But I voted for number three because he's kept Tom and Jerry good and violent the way I like it.
That's the way we go, friends. And I'm not going to have the gentleman stand up. Better than that, who better to pick out his creator, the Bill Hanna, than Yogi Bear himself? Yogi, will you come out here and show us which one is a fellow who thunk you up?
He does look like number one.
I
think it is number one.
Oh, it's number... No, he says not. No, it's not number two. Daddy.
Yeah. You know what made me right? You know what made me right?
Oh, my. All right. Fine, Bill. Let's go on down the line and find out who we all are. Number two, sir, what is your real name? What do you do?
I'm Frank Joyce, and I'm Southern Sales Manager for the New York Subways Advertising Company.
Nice to have you here. And number three, tell me about you, please.
I'm Tommy White. I own the Giraffe Restaurant on East 58th Street in New York City.
It's a great place. Bill, very nice to have you with us. And there must be something special that brings you and Yogi to New York. What is it?
Well, Yogi told me he was tired of his cave. He wanted a new cave, so we have been what you would call cave hunting.
And have you found a location?
Yes, we have. Found him a new home. It's a beautiful new home in a brand new park. It's in Richmond, Virginia, and it's called King's Dominion. It's going to be the only bear cave that has hot and cold running geysers.
Well, now, Bill, it's been an honor for us to meet you. Yogi, certainly an honor to meet you, my friend.
Sweet.
Take care, gentlemen, also. Thank you very much for being with us.